It's day 18, just outside Vilnius in Lithuania. As the coach heads out of the woods today, it's in for a big surprise.
It's a beautiful day.
Two new tourists, Zed and his wife Sapphire.
We're very excited to be here.
And I'm so looking forward to it. Honestly, we're going to have a party on that bus.
OK, ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to introduce you to Sapphire and Zed.
People always take an interest when they meet us. They find us an interesting couple, especially when we're glammed up. People think, oh, are they pop stars or something?
So, ladies and gentlemen, can we please welcome Sapphire and Zed to the coach?
Thank you. My name is Sapphire. I'm a singer-songwriter.
My name is Zed. I'm also a singer-songwriter with Sapphire in the music industry, and I also produce music as well.
We've been married for 19 years, but known each other for 20, oh. And we're so much in love.
Oh, lovely.
They seem really nice.
Just seem so in love as well, which is really, you know, it's rare to see.
Well, welcome to the coach, guys. Excellent, welcome.
So Zed and Sapphire joined the bus today. Being kind of glad it was getting a little bit too normal. There's these small characters chucked in.
If you could interview anyone famous in the world, like, who would you choose?
I'd probably like to interview Bono. People get confused for me when I've got Bono glasses on. One occasion it did happen, I went through Heathrow Airport and I got free food, free drinks. These are the type of glasses that I was wearing.
Did you not have to speak in an Irish accent?
I did, yeah, I did. I just went over to the guy and I said, very pleased to meet you.
He looks about as much like Bono as I do Trevor McDonald, quite frankly. I'm not buying that he's had free stuff on the back of being Bono.
He raps. He's a rapper.
Oh, why didn't this come up in conversation previously?
Just when you think you might be getting a bit tired, say bus out a quick freestyle, lightens the mood.
So everybody in a place to be, running out like I'm Ice-T, got the microphone mic in hand, and I'm one man band.
My eyebrows nearly hit my hairline. I was absolutely astonished.
The coach is going along the road and we're going for a drive. Everybody, microphone master, cut like cheese and cut disaster.
He just made it up instantly and it just rolled off his tongue. He's obviously very accomplished at rapping.
Wheels in the bus go round and round. Wheels in the coach, a penny for the pound.
I don't know whether he was being serious or... Because if he was being serious...
Bus is going down the road. I'm no toad.
I'm not a toad.
Bit at the end with the toad bit, just sort of like, OK.
I had tears streaming down my face.
In fairness, had he not said that, we all could have been under the illusion that he was indeed a toad.
But if that wasn't enough, there's another less jovial surprise lurking deep in the forest.
There's a Russian guy here with a big dog.
Oh, where are we? Oh, God, he looks scary.
What just happened? We stopped in, like, the middle of nowhere. This dog come on a bus with his man.
Here. We've got our passports. Get our passports. We're British.
I'm not known for my bravery. So when an angry Lithuanian soldier and a crazy Alsatian come marching on the bus demanding documents, my face did drop a little bit, I'm not gonna lie.
As soon as we got off the bus.
Oh my God, the dog. The dog is the most scariest dog I've ever seen in my life.
I took off like the $6 million man. I thought it was gonna bite me in the backside.
They needn't be too scared, as this is all part of Brendan's master plan for the afternoon. The group are being taken back 30 years. To Soviet-era Lithuania in an immersive museum experience which will give them a taste of life under the notorious KGB's secret police.
Bit of culture, bit of history. Won't go amiss. Well, might go amiss on some of these.
Oh my
God. This other crazy military guy come out, told me off of my sunglasses on my head.
They were just, like, so strict, and we all had to stand there like this. And then you got this translator that's... This woman just looks so even more strict.
Now, a couple of words about Soviet Union.
This
is the happiest country in the world. It will be quiet very soon.
Lauren was a naughty one of the group. Well, she just couldn't stop laughing. I mean, she was crying.
Stop it. You'll get sent to jail.
And I just could not stop laughing. They were all a little petrified, even the men.
About 15 minutes in, Will leant over to me and whispered, "Is this real?" The USSR hasn't existed in quite a long time, so I caught on quite quickly that this might not be genuine.
Genuine or not, Craig, this is one experience you won't forget in a hurry.
Then we get marched into some kind of...
Bunker,
yeah.
dog scared me the most. At one point, we'd have to run past the dog and the dog would be there attacking like this.
Then we went downstairs. We had to put these gas masks on.
They felt horrible, they smelt.
You put it on and you're gagging instantly. Some of them couldn't handle it.
I'm not putting that on, that's sickening.
Really had trouble keeping it on without actually throwing up in it. And there's Lorna standing next to me, worrying about her hair.
No one was wearing hair like mine back then, were they, really? Shaved off or something. I feel pretty,
oh, so pretty. It was all humid inside and all sweaty. They did inform us, oh, they disinfected them, I thought, aye, and the rest.
Lauren couldn't stop laughing. She was giggling all the time and they told her off quite a few times. In the end, they took her out.
Carter!
I don't like it!
Carter!
And that were it. Took her off.
Guys, put your masks on.
Locked her in, pitch black.
I moved the bed, I moved the chair, thinking they'd open the door, but they didn't. They left me, so I just sat on, knocking on the door.
Brendan!
I could just hear her screaming from down the hallway.
Brendan!
And they took me upstairs to this horrible woman. She made me pull my top up and, like, just, like, she went across with, like, this thing, this piece of equipment.
No way.
Oh, God.
No way. Oh. No, I don't like needles.
Oh. Put cotton wool into my mouth.
Oh, good girls. No.
She had a massive needle and I thought she was going to jab me with it. Mm-hmm. It was like a horror movie, basically.
You can't say stop, Lauren. It's just a museum. While she tries to negotiate her way out of the dentist's, the others are about to get a mouthful of something else.
You are in the best restaurant in the country.
They did give you, like, a nice pastry that looked like it'd been there for about a week. Some green juice, a bit random. The vodka was nice at the end, though. Yeah.
That vodka was very strong, yeah. It was like medicine. The way I downed it, it felt like I was body popping.
Tastes delicious. It was really nice.
Oh,
jeez. I just waited until the survey officer wasn't looking. Cheeky chuck over the shoulder and did the old, face. I think I got away with it.
I was just like, knock it back and it will make everything feel better.
With the liberated Lauren back with the main group, everyone can make a break for freedom.
As soon as the dog barked, there was a wheel-shaped blur down the bunker.
There's Carol and Bill in front of me.
And everyone's just
and
like,
everyone just ran past them. I was like, oh, bye, Carol.
They were happy to let them be eaten up by the Alsatians to try and get out the door.
We had to run down this long, long tunnel, and Will and I, we took off.
Lorna's just totally left me.
You did have trainers on, and at any point, you could have moved a little bit quicker.
I did try.
Today it is by far out and out the craziest, weirdest thing we've done.
From now on, maybe I'll like my holidays with a pinch of communist dictatorship. Who knows?
Usually at the end of activity, we would thank everybody, you know, we're polite people, but they did shout us. I don't think they deserved a thank you.
And I gave the tourists a real insight into how the Lithuanians lived under Russian rule. And after that, I don't think they'll be back.
So they've escaped relatively unscathed, but will they all make it through to tomorrow? After tonight's vote. Currently on a yellow card are Sharon and Lauren, Dino and Sherelle, and Will and Craig. As Zed and Sapphire are new, they can vote, but the others can't vote for them.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Here we are in Vilnius, and it's time for another vote. The couple who gets the most votes this evening will be awarded a yellow card. We need to know who you're voting for and your reasons why. Thank you.
Tonight we are voting for Carol and Bill, unfortunately. Bill's really funny, but don't understand your humour. When you're telling jokes, I've got to, like, listen twice. That's the reason why, sorry.
That's fine, don't worry about it. I'm thinking that some of his jokes are rather old. And with you being so young, you probably wouldn't understand them anyway. Tonight, we're voting for Will and Craig. It's just that you've been on the coach longer than anyone, and if anyone needs to be voted off at the end of the day, I think you should be the first to go.
At this stage of the trip, a lot of people kind of
the easiest one to go for is the guys who have been there the longest, so it's not the first time someone's done it, so that's cool.
Yeah, great.
Tonight we are voting for Carol and Bill. Nothing really against you, I think you're great guys. Obviously tonight there are three of us on yellow cards who we have been on the coach with the longest, and we got on really well, so it was really
just thought we'd share the yellow cards, really.
Well, yeah. we can appreciate that.
You never know, you might join the yellow card club.
Yeah, yeah.
The way it's going with
that. Tomorrow's
it's a good club to be in.
Tonight, we're voting for Sharon and Lauren. I'm so sorry, guys, but the last activity, I just thought that the laughing and stuff was just going on a bit too long, and I think it got to sort of everybody, I think, a bit.
That's fine.
It's fine.
Honest to God, I'm here just to have fun, and if my laughing gets on your nerves, then I do apologise, but that's me.
It's not that it got on our nerves.
No, it's me.
It's the fact that it could have got worse, and these guys could have made us do painstaking exercises.
Yeah. We were scared that was going to happen.
Yeah, I agree that.
That's really the reason.
Honest to God, I understand. It's fine.
Tonight we've actually decided to vote for Bill and Carol. We think you're absolutely amazing. It's just the others are on yellow cards, and we just want everybody to stay together. It's been such a brilliant day, and we'd like to continue it that way. So. Sorry, we do think you're brilliant, though.
Thank you.
It's really nice of you to say that you think we're brilliant.
Yeah,
that
you
really
are
is.
Absolutely you amazing, Peria.
We accept your vote.
Tonight, we're voting for Carol and Bill. It's just basically, it's this stage of the game. We don't want to see anyone go home. And there's three of us on yellow cards, which left us two people to vote for. Out of the two, we felt we had probably more in common with the two girls. So we're voting for you tonight, I'm afraid.
Yeah, in our minds, we only had two pairs to choose from, really. We didn't want to vote for anyone a yellow card. And obviously, we were sat opposite Lorna and Joe. We're kind of from the same place, have a lot of the same interests. So that was it, really. It was the only thing we could split between the two of you.
Oh, that's great. We don't mind joining the yellow card brigade at all. That's not a problem, guys. That's great. It really is. Yeah. Appreciate
it. Don't worry about it.
Ladies and gentlemen, the result of this evening's vote, with four votes against you, I award Carol and Bill your first yellow card.
Thank you.
That actually concludes this evening's vote. Thank
you. We're in the club.
Yay!
These trousers, yellow. Why did I put yellow trousers on? I should have put a different colour on and we might not have had a yellow card. But we're in the club.
Next time. The group find inner peace.
That is me relaxed, honestly.
Take a slight detour.
This is ridiculous!
And at the vote, Zed loses a member of his fan club.
I find your rapping great, and to be fair.
Fair enough, but it got me a music publishing deal.
Don't know where.
It's the largest man-made structure on the planet, surviving immense forces of nature, the passage of time, and all-out war.
This is not just history, it's part of the world's geography.
But what do we really know about the Great War?